A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th November, Sunday, on the front page you have Temple at disputed site, mosque within Ayodhya, rules Supreme Court. So center has been told to set up a trust to manage the property and build Ram Temple. Sunni Central Wakf Board should be given 5-acre plot for mosque. And Babri Masjid demolition, it is said, is an egregious violation of the rule of law. And it said all form of belief, worship and prayer are equal. So these are the important, you know, statements which have been given by the Supreme Court in its judgment. And Sunni Wakf Board has said that it will not seek a review of judgment. But All India Muslim Personal Law Board is considering curative petition, means an appeal against this judgment also being filed. Then this is first batch of 562 pilgrims, all prays for Kartarpur facilities. So Prime Minister thanks Imran Khan, the Prime Minister of Pakistan, workers for completion of Kartarpur corridor, and the inaugural group was flagged off, which included even union ministers and Punjab chief minister. Then you have Bulbul batters several coastal districts of Odisha and Bengal. So this is the cyclonic storm Bulbul, which has affected the some districts of Odisha and also West Bengal. So you can see its speed touching 60 km per hour continued to prevail over Puri, Jagatsinghpur, Kendrapara, Jajpur, Balasore, Bhadrak and Puri districts of Odisha. On page 8 you have pilgrims apprehensive ahead of Mandalam season. So tensions over women's entry in Sabarimala may hit arrivals in this Mandalam annual festival, which will annual season, which will be there at Sabarimala Ayyappa temple in Kerala. And here you have this atlas helps access environmental health. So for the first time, a geochemical baseline atlas of India has been developed by CSIR, National Geophysical Research Institute, for use by policymakers to assess environmental damage. So this atlas consists of 15 maps of metals, oxides and elements present in top and bottom soils across India. And then here you have this bullock cart race at Bhimli Utsav, organized by Andhra Pradesh Tourism Development Corporation. So we have seen how various festivals involving animals, you know, Jallikattu of Tamil Nadu to even other festivals from other southern states too, they all have been, you know, criticized as such. Supreme Court has banned them as such too. And this is bullock cart race of Andhra Pradesh called at Bhimli Utsav. Bhimli Utsav. And this is tiger conservation gets boost in AP. So, in Andhra Pradesh, Tiger Conservation Foundation has, through its efforts, ensured that the number of tigers in Nagarjuna Asylum, Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Asylum Tiger Reserve has increases. So, the tiger number has increased here. There was steady decline in the number over a period of time. So, now they're increasing. Increase of 6 tigers in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana has been observed. So, Tiger Conservation Foundation has decided to hike environment maintenance charge and use the funds for anti-poaching activities too in the Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Asylum Tiger Reserve of Andhra Pradesh. On page 9, you have Odisha hit by over 9 lakh lightning strikes this year. So, 5 states have accounted for half of the cloud-to-ground strikes according to the study. And they are West Bengal, Odisha, Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. And maximum are in Orisha. Cloud to cloud flash clashes and in cloud flashes. Then below you have World Health Organization initiative to expand access to affordable insulin. So ahead of the World Diabetes Day on November 14, World Health Organization is launching an initiative which is to have affordable insulin available to all. So it is said more than 420 million people worldwide, mostly in low and middle income countries, live with diabetes. There's a need for insulin and they don't have access to it, affordable insulin. So this is what the World Health Organization has done. You know, so here you can see the patients. It is said to be the maximum patients are in China. Second comes India. So it will make insulin, affordable insulin available to them. So it's a non-communicable disease, diabetes. Then on page 11, you have addendum course Tulsidas N. Akbari for birthplace proof. So for proof that Ram temple existed at the site before Babri Masjid was established, so for that the Supreme Court addendum quotes it is believing in the words in Tulsidas and N. Akbari for birthplace proof, and it said no harm in trusting these works, such faith is not groundless. So N. Akbari is a 16th century document written by Abul Fazl which deals with the administration of Mughal Emperor Akbar. So it mentions the time of birth of Lord Ram as Treta Yug in the city of Ayodhya. And also Tulsidas not only refers to the birth of Lord Ram but also points out to a place where he will take human form. But then within Ayodhya, even Babri Masjid has been demolished and another site has been given within Ayodhya for Babri Masjid. So specifically where Babri Masjid was located, there was a temple over here. That proof is not there, but these earlier documents proof have been taken into consideration. Then on Sundays, you have FAQ coverage. So, this is complete coverage on Ayodhya dispute, the Ram Janmabhoomi title dispute. So, when did the dispute start and why did it take so long for resolution? The complete detail is given here. On page 14, you have Imran welcomes pilgrims to Kartarpur. So, the inaugural Indian team, including ministers, 117 MLAs and MPs, have been welcomed by Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan. So, the detail regarding Kartarpur Sahib Corridor to how it finally came into effect and has been inaugurated now. So, we saw in news yesterday that Brazilian former president Lula da Silva, he may be released after the Supreme Court verdict which allows convicts to be released after, in first appeal they have been convicted. So, Lula vows to keep fighting for the poor now. So he has said that he has been wrongly framed in corruption charges by opposition leaders who are now in power. And this is Iraq forces clear protest sites as leaders defend government. So in Iraq also public protests are going on. So the police forces as such, security forces have cleared those protest sites. So the leaders are defending the government. Nearly 300 people have died in these protests which are going on for more than a month now. So Hong Kong protests are also going on. And here you have Bangladesh moves citizens away from coast. So Bangladesh authorities ordered more than 4 lakh people to flee coastal villages and islands as cyclone Bulbul headed for the Bay of Bengal coast. So from Odisha and West Bengal, it will move towards Bangladesh. And Bangladesh has moved, the issued orders to move its people. On business page, you have oil PSUs begin export of diesel as domestic demand contracts. So state-owned refiners, Indian Oil Corporation Limited, Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited and Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited began exporting diesel for the first time as demand for the fuel has registered a contraction on a year-on-year basis in the second quarter. So, it has been impacted by extended monsoon and slowing auto sales. And this is India-EU to push for free trade pact again. So this is the bilateral trade and investment agreement, BTIA, which was being negotiated between USA, between India and EU. So this will again be pushed up. So it has been long pending negotiations which have been going on. You can see bilateral trade and investment agreement. Then on Sundays, you have science and technology coverage. So here, first is Indian Institute of Science. So it has found that natural shield protects certain DNA regions from radiation damage. So when exposed to radiation, there were fewer breaks in G quadruplexes present in the telomeres. So some parts of DNA, they protect themselves. There's a natural shield for them against radiation damage. So this has been found in this study. And this is regarding India's efforts towards mitigating climate change. So what India is doing for tackling climate change. So this is detail out here. And this is superbug crisis. Are doctors to blame? So antimicrobial resistance is one of the most significant challenges the world is facing today when the microbes become resistant to antibiotics. So it is said doctors are responsible for 10% or less of global misuse of antibiotics. So what are the other reasons? What are major causes is to be understood is what this article says. Over 2/3 of the antibiotics manufactured by pharmaceutical industry are used as growth promoters for poultry and cattle. So that results in antimicrobial resistance entering into human food chain too. So that is a major factor highlighted. And this is seaweed extract shows antiretroviral activity. So this is a seaweed extract which has medicinal properties. So this is a compound, bioactive compound extracted from the seaweed from two macroalgae. So it shows anti-HIV-1 effect in lab tests. Then on Sundays, you also have dispatches coverage in which important international news are picked up and detailed out. So first one is, with Lula's release, a reset in Brazilian politics is on the card. So this we have seen in today's newspaper too and even yesterday news. And this is regarding Tokyo. It says, when ministers quit for bribing voters with melons and mangoes. So when for many in Japan, it is said two recent resignations show there is little leeway in the country for graft. You cannot bribe voters as such, and if attempts are done for it, you can see they finally had to quit. And this is a rite of autumn that has survived wars, crises and calamities. So this is called Halloween's modern variant. So it was brought to the US by immigrants, mostly Irish. So this talks about this Halloween as such, which you can skip. And this is again regarding China. It says urban laboratory of President Xi's vision. So it says Shenzhen has been given the role of a pilot demonstration area for the leader's philosophy. So what China plans to achieve, the reforms which it wants. So Shenzhen has been made a model city showcasing socialist imagination of urbanization at the highest level. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.